Welcome back to PXP channel. In the last video, we built the bare bone Spring Boot application. In this video, we will go ahead and create all the other components that are required to build the complete CRUD application. Let's get started. Let's go ahead and create the packages. We will click on the package and we will name the packages com.pxp.employee-database.model. We will start with a model package. And let's copy the entire string so that it will be useful to create other packages. This time we will create another package and let's name it as entity. And let's create another package. This time let's name it as repository. And this package will be named as dot service. This will be our final package and let's name it as com.pxp.employee-database.controller. That's it, we are ready with all the packages. Now that all the packages are ready, let's go ahead and create a model class. Within the model package, let's name it as employee. Let's click on finish. This is the class and we will create a couple of properties. We will only create three properties. First one will be ID. Second property will be first name and the last one will be last name. Now we will create another class and let's name it as employee entity. This will be entity class. We will annotate with this class with entity so that it will talk to the database, meaning we will use this class to connect to the database and interact with the database. Let's create the constructor and getters and setters. This is the NoAr constructor with all the fields. Okay, that's it. Let's annotate this class with the entity because we will also have to annotate the first field with at ID property because this is the primary key and we will make it as auto-generated and we will ask Hibernate to generate the key automatically. So let's import all the relevant imports. And let's mark this class as entity by adding the annotation at the right entity. That is done. Let's create another interface. And this is for repository because we will need the repository to deal with the database, meaning we'll have to connect with the database and fetch data from the database using this interface. And it is, let's name it as employee repository and we will have to extend JPA repository and let's use the entity name that will be let's annotate this interface with @ repository annotation so that this way we are telling Hibernate that this is a repository interface and it should be treated that way. And the good thing about JPA repository is we will only have to define the methods and the implementation will be taken care by the Hibernate. So we are defining the methods here. And the first method is a public boolean exists by first name and last name. The significance of this method will be known in subsequent tutorials. We will see how we will use this method, but for now let's define it. And this method will accept two parameters, first name and last name. And also we will define another method that is exist by ID. This method is already available by default, but the parameter accepted by this method is string, but we will define another method which will accept integer ID. We will also see the usage of this method little later. That's it for now. In the next tutorial, we will develop the service class.